All right, everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So today I'm going to be freezing honey, as you can see here, with liquid nitrogen, as you can see there. Now, I've frozen honey with dry ice before, and dry ice is 109 degrees below zero, but nitrogen boils at 320 degrees below zero, so it's much, much colder. In fact, liquid nitrogen is to dry ice what dry ice is to room temperature. In fact, it's even more than that. One thing I'd really like to test is to see whether I could make something similar to Prince Rupert drops, because honey, when liquid, is very similar to molten glass. So maybe I could actually make something that would look very much like those Prince Rupert drops things. I've placed a little bit of honey in this spoon here, and now I'm just going to wait for it to drizzle off and put a single drop into the liquid. This is some very, very slow honey. Doesn't help that it's being quite cold next to the liquid nitrogen here. It goes into liquid. Let's snip that off right there, if I can. There we go. That's really bubbling. It's taking a long time to cool off. Now my chopsticks are sticky. Oh, I just heard something shatter. It blew up. See if I can fish out what's left of it. Come on, honey. Okay, I think I got one. There's a piece of the honey. Let's have a look at this. Yeah, it's certainly shattered, isn't it? Let's break it. It just turns to powder when I crush it. It almost looks like tempered glass. Look at that. Okay, new plan. I'm going to see if I can drop in a smaller drop of honey from a greater height. That way, it'll have more time to separate from the tail. Goes into the thing. Okay. See if that works. Oh, I just heard the shatter. Let's see if I can pull it out with this. Yeah, no. Totally broke off. There we go. Now we can see something. Oh, look at that. Crunchy honey. All right, let's get rid of this. Let's try this again. Now this time I'm gonna leave the spoon very close to the nitrogen. That way it doesn't have a long tail that can get broke off and possibly trigger it. So once it forms a pretty nice drop, I'm just gonna plunge it in and let it slowly drop into the nitrogen. Here we go. Let it go in. There it is. It just broke anyway. Dang it. Let's try it with a great big drop of honey. There it goes. So far so good, and it just broke. I don't know if you saw that. Yeah, just crumbles. Oh well. It's looking to me like it's not gonna actually make the Prince Rupert drop type of thing, because the honey, since it contains water, actually it expands as it freezes. So it just, once it gets cold in the middle, it just shatters it. So I don't think this is actually possible. It was an interesting idea though. So let's try one more thing with this frozen honey. You see, honey has a very low specific heat, or rather it has very low heat conduction, so it takes a long time to change temperature, as you could see when I was putting it into the nitrogen. Which makes me wonder if I could actually try eating some of it. Here we go, frozen chunk of honey. How about that? I think I froze my tongue just a little bit, but otherwise I'm okay. It's still very cold and crunchy. That is interesting. And now it's like melding. All right. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.